Am I really ready for an electric RV?
No, at this point.
The answer is clear. Ooh, coming down to the wire.
Yeah, it's been quite a drive.
Oh my God, when they say California traffic, they mean California traffic. It's crazy.
Exactly. Don't drive from Vegas to San Diego on a Sunday afternoon.
Bad idea.
Welcome to California. Such a lonely place.
So we are off now on our next adventure, except this time we're not heading into the snow. We're going to be heading into a little bit of warmer-ish pastures. And our first stop is to a place that's supposed to be California's largest gas station. And what is it called, Dave?
I think it's like Eddie's World or something.
Eddie's World! It looks very windy out there.
Watch out, yeah.
All right, so while Dave is getting gas, I'm gonna give you a little idea about what's about to happen. So we're basically heading to San Diego, California. And what we're doing there is we'll be swapping our Winnebago Echo for something very different, a little special, but hopefully one of the coolest RVs we have ever seen. And maybe you as well.
Oh my goodness gracious, lots and lots of Teslas. Tesla charging station at Eddie's World.
Get your Tesla on right here.
Charged up.
Or charged, yeah, something like that.
First stop on the road trip is Eddie's World. Dave, what do you think?
Well, I gotta say, this is surprising here, right? Seeing part of the original court of the Great Western Forum where the Lakers played, and they played there from 67 through 99.
Wow.
So basically like Magic and all those championships that those great Laker teams won were played on this court.
There it is.
Now, being from Boston, I do have mixed emotions about this, right? Of course, you had the great Bird Magic battles that went through the 80s, but
which they kind of have a lovely
picture. Yeah, they got it right there.
There's the battle. Oh boy.
Memories.
That is. Look, they're going. Look, they're going for it. Going for the ball. There it is. So Dave, what are we getting?
Well, pesto pizza.
Ah, the good old pesto pizza. You can't go wrong with that, right?
What do you think, babe?
I think I'm already making a mess, but I think it actually looks really, really good.
Messes are good.
Messes are great. Actually, they said it was one of their best pizzas. So I'm liking it. The pesto, the hot tomato, extra crispy on that thin crust. You know what I'm about to say? Yum, yum, give me some. Mission accomplished. Off to our final destination in 5 hours.
Exactly. Got some driving to do.
So there's only three pieces left to bring into the new little tiny home on wheels, and that's Grogu and the kitty. So Dave's getting them right now, and that should be it, and then we're off. Oh my goodness, look who it is.
All right, I got a little drizzle out there.
Oh, you protected Grogu.
New home.
There's your spot right there for now.
And of course.
Oh, you cannot go anywhere without our leading mascot, Grogu.
Welcome to your new home.
Bailey's first. Hi, Bailey.
Hi.
Here comes number two.
I think he's like looking the other way.
Oh, he's like, oh, I got the butt shot.
Hi, Bobby.
So it's going to be their first time in a new RV. Let's see how Bailey, she's usually the one that'll react perfectly fine and kind of come out and explore. Yep, there she goes. Oh, Kira's up in this spot.
So here's Big Boy now. I'm a little nervous with this with Brady because I know he's gonna take some time to adjust. Oh wait, I think he sees Bailey. Go explore.
So how do you like driving it?
It's great. It's you know, it's under 20 feet, so yeah. It feels much smaller than the Echo.
Yeah.
Like it just does. It's, yeah, the Echo's 23 feet, but it just feels bigger. This year, you feel like you're really driving a van.
It feels like it's,
yeah,
too.
Right?
I feel lower.
Yeah.
I feel like we're actually part of the car crowd.
Yeah, we're definitely lower, yes.
But it's super cool. It does ride smooth.
It does, yeah,
and
it's smooth.
And it's quieter in here.
It is quieter.
The ride definitely feels quieter, obviously because you don't have that big beefy tires and all that
right.
other stuff in there added to it, but it's kind of cozy. So first destination is, we're gonna explore a little bit of San Diego, right? And
yeah.
So we're heading to
you're checking out La Jolla, little neighborhood.
Hey, yeah. I'm excited to check out La Jolla.
We've never been here.
Never been here. We're gonna get some good eats. Gonna check out now. It's a cloudy day, unfortunately, but it's supposed to have a really beautiful cove there, La Jolla Cove, with us, you know, sea lions and things like that.
Oh man.
Yeah, so we'll see.
All right, we are all set and ready to rock, right?
I'm excited, kind of maiden voyage.
What is the plan?
Yeah, well, we're gonna check out a little San Diego, maybe head up to La Jolla.
Oh, La Jolla.
Kind of see, maybe start trying to find some hidden gems.
Hidden gems
up there.
That.
I am a little worried about parking. When you look at parking, there's a lot of parking garages where this, I don't see this thing fitting. So fingers crossed on finding a good parking spot up there.
It'd be fun to kind of try stealth camping,
oh,
if possible.
Yes.
Since we're in a smaller, this is a van style, so you can get away with it.
I've never really tried it.
And because it's all electric, it's quiet. So you can sneak up anywhere. Because it's sneaking to a spot, just sneaking in. I also have to say, and it's pretty exciting, we are the first folks in this RV. This was just built, so we're the first ones testing it out. Whether that's good or bad, we shall find out.
Exactly. We're going to find all the kinks.
We get to try it out. Oh, I already like the new Ford system here. We don't have this.
Hey, we need this. This big screen. Look at that with the backup. It's just perfect.
And this is cool.
That's cool.
It shows you kind of how you're parked in the spot. That is like, it's like a 360 kind of
holy
camera.
Holy cromungas.
That so, is so cool.
And it can tell you if you're good distance.
Yeah, I love it.
That's really cool. Nice job.
All right, now one of the benefits of the small transit van is you can fit into definitely regular parking spots, more so than the Echo for sure.
Oh yeah.
Right,
look at this. Look how tiny, and that one, see that one right there?
That big one, just look at the spot right here, and he just could not get into it, a Class C.
Exactly.
He's just going off down the hill right there. He was like, I'm second guessing whether we can get into this spot or
exactly.
not. But we can get into this spot because it's tiny.
Inside the tunnel, they are slipping.
So you have to actually head through the tunnel.
There's 145 steps through this tunnel.
And they say be careful, it can be slippery.
It can be slippery.
Well, we did the Bunker Hill monument.
I was going to
so
say, the Bunker
we can do
Hill
this.
Monument. Yeah.
Although this looks a little creepy.
And it's low ceiling, so it looks a little creepy.
Whoa, big
dun, 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 dun. I'm walking through the cave. I better also behave, because they're watching me as I'm watching them watching me.
It
still goes on. We're still going.
All right, babe, so rumor has it this is an old bootlegger tunnel.
Right.
Not sure if it's true or not, to kind of bring the liquor kind of through here and then up through the tunnel.
The only way to bring it.
The only way to bring it, apparently.
And what is that shape on?
It looks like a head.
I guess so, a little nose, a head, or something.
Yeah, of something special.
What is that?
I saw a postcard up there. It looked like the shape of someone's head.
Yeah. Yeah, and if folks have ideas of what it looks like, let us know in the comments below
what
for
does
sure.
It look like? It looks like a head.
Now the real trek begins, Dave.
I know, we're heading up.
140 plus steps. Any place here, you gotta have some good gifts. I'm talking buttons and pins and postcards. All of your must-haves when you come to a cool little shop like this.
Well, that was really cool. And if you're interested, it's called Sunny Jim's Sea Cave. And if you're in La Jolla, just look for the, right here, look for the cave store. And that's actually the entrance to the cave. The pricing is $10 per adult. The minors, 2 to 17, it's $6.
Never having been in San Diego, it feels like definitely a town that could be just jumping and This one here in particular in San Diego, La Jolla, feels like it's just gonna jump off at any moment, especially on the weekends. Lots of restaurants, lots of little shops here, and just a lot of really interesting spots. And that sea air.
I know.
Just breathing in that sea air.
It's like the sea air, and then also some like grills going or something.
Yeah.
So I smell a combination of food and the sea. It's like perfection. Mm. It's perfection.
Seafood.
Mm. You got it, I like
Ooh.
That.
Ooh. So this is a very popular spot here in La Jolla, San Diego, called Puesto. It's sort of a Mexican-inspired vibe. Lots of different options on the menu. Certainly on the pricier side, but if you get here happy hour, which I believe is between 3 and 5 p.m. Pacific, you can actually go for the shared plates, which is what we're doing, snacks and shares. You get $10 margaritas, which is the Puesto margarita, and we're gonna mix and match that because half off means full stomachs. Look at those four options. Sauces there, right?
It's really cool. I heard was spicy on this one.
Yeah, that looks spicy.
So I gotta try this one.
You better be careful.
Here we go.
You better be careful. Uh-oh.
Here we go, ready?
I'm ready.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
It'll open you right up though. All that
Woo!
Stuff you got going on in there.
Woo!
It'll open you right up.
That should taste really good. So I can hear them crackling.
Yes. So we got the chicharrones, which is the crackling pork skins. Nice dipping sauce. Potato taquitos, which is nice. You can also dip those in those different sauces, which I think you're really going to like. And cheers to the perfect margarita.
I got to say, babe, we definitely took advantage of the happy hour.
Why?
Well, everything we got, including the margarita, $28.
What?
That's pretty good, what? Right?
I'd buy that.
Yeah, I like it. Excellent. Yeah.
These guys almost just like a combination of cormorants and storks of some sort and seagulls.
Right.
But it's an island full of them.
This is an amazing spot, right? I mean, there's so many sea lions and seals just like hanging out. We have some time to kill before we can check into our next destination, and Tanya and I are both feeling tired, so we found this industrial park, which is right by a marina here just south of San Diego. We can actually stealth camp until 9 p.m. this evening, so we're gonna put our shades up, get comfortable inside, take a nap, and probably cook a light dinner as well before we head on to our next destination.
And really quick, for those of you not familiar with stealth camping, it's just the ability to be able to park and look like you're parked without camping, even though you're camping on the inside. So we're gonna block off the shades here and just chill. I'm gonna make some dinner. I'm excited. The kitties will finally be able to come out and peek around and be nosy. But it's time for me to close off some of those shades, because back there in particular, look, you can even see there's a car back there, and they might be inside camping as well, because they have all the shades up on all four sides, so they're probably in there taking a nap or chilling.
So first and foremost, I'm gonna zip up the back here, and that should black everything out, so you won't be able to see anything out there.
So I'm gonna pass you these so you can put these in, block up the front. Let the stealthing really begin. Hey Dave.
What?
Looks pretty stealthy to me out there.
Right? Nice.
Yeah, not bad. All right.
Well, I'm gonna take a little nap, I think, in here for a bit. You wanna take a nap?
Yeah, I'm gonna actually get some stuff prepped and then I'll come join you.
Okay, thanks, babe.
All right.
Oh, look at you, you look cozy.
It's really cozy in here, babe. Oh, you have like no idea you're actually like right by an industrial park.
Yeah.
We could be anywhere. It's just cozy in here right now.
It's super cozy. You forget that you've got some barbed wire next to you on the outside.
Exactly.
I can make it even cozier for you. You ready?
Okay, here we go.
Cozy mode. Back.
I like it.
So I am gonna bust out the induction. All right, so I got some chicken and bacon skewers. Look at those four puppies, like lollipop style.
Those look amazing.
Right, chicken and bacon skewers. Wow. With a little bit of red chili on there, salt, pepper. It's gonna have a really nice, it's gonna smell so good. You're gonna wanna like.
Yeah, this rig is gonna smell like heaven.
Oh, it's gonna smell like heaven. I mean, if you can't smell this from the outside, you got smelling problems.
Oh, look who came up.
I think it's because he smells the bacon.
Oh, he's
Bobby, do you smell the bacon? You smell the bacon?
There you go, honey pie.
Oh, thank you, baby.
You got the blue bowl for you.
Wow.
And the pink one for Ma.
Looks amazing.
Yeah, I want to see how it tastes.
All right.
You can take one for the team the first bite.
Oh, hot.
Ooh.
Mmm.
Lots of flavor.
Oh, my God.
Juicy.
That is so good, babe.
Ah, oh, high five.
That's amazing. Thank you so much.
Awesome skewers. I am definitely feeling like it's time for a little power nap.
Oh, I agree completely. It's right. it's like a bacon heaven in here with the aroma.
Ooh, right, bacon heaven.
I got my baby.
Ooh.
Right, a little comfy spot.
Yeah.
I'm just taking a nap.
I like that. Good night. Well, we did it. We have quite a bit of battery left to spare. We're heading to what we're gonna call home for the next night or two. We'll see. Power, we have fresh sea air as always, and look, there it is. That's where we're gonna be able to go home.
And a parking lot on the beach.
And a parking lot.
Well, we wanted to camp along the beach. Looks like we're gonna do that. We'll see how nice it is.
I know.
Right? It looks very busy.
Do we have a spot?
We do. Okay. We do have a spot.
Okay, good. We have that. Oh, look at that notice. Gates are locked at 8 p.m. No vehicle access in or out.
That's amazing.
So once we're in, once that gate closes, we're in.
Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo. I know, there's no leaving.
No leaving. I camping fees here. Beach Row, which is a premium spot, $85. Inland Row, which is regular spots, is $65. So. All right, look at you. Look at our
right?
Beds. Look at our view.
That's quite the view.
That's our view.
I can't wait until the weather gets nice.
I know. Now I'm curious to see how we're going to plug up the...
I know.
How are they going to plug
up? Getting the plugs out here.
All right, I'm coming outside so I can see this.
Ah.
This is a little charging system, so...
Yeah, this is not the normal kind of plug.
No, it's not.
Okay.
Pop it open.
Manual pop open. I see.
All right, take out the little...
Yes.
Spot there and then...
See that? And then give it a
right
go.
Right in. All right, there it goes.
And it's in, and the light is on.
Light's going.
It's fine. Uh-huh. And see, it's kind of showing right there due to the light when it's fully charged. This will all be complete, and I think it'll change colors.
Right.
I know it's really windy, but look, this is the beach. This is going to be our view right here for the next several nights. So the real deal is now for me to get everything comfortable so I can make dinner. Spot for the kitties so they can kind of relax without being freaked out, because right now they're a little freaked out. And then we're gonna make the bed and see what that feels and looks like in here, because right now it's cozy but tight. So Dave is letting me relax and he's in charge of making the bed. So how's it going over there with that bed?
It's going. It's going awesome.
All right, babe. So Tanya is taking over the job.
I'm taking over.
I had a little casualty.
Yes.
Bloody knuckles.
But boy, you know what's going to be really fun? The fact that we can sleep in a safe
bed! Exactly, look at that. Yay.
And it's so big.
I know, right? It looks good.
It's comfortable. All you do is you insert that there. For those van lifers, you know this. Push the button, give it a good turn till it tightens in place.
Nice job.
Boom. And then you let it go.
Voila. Boom.
Voila.
It's solid.
Like a dance. Dance a pole.
Oh, wow.
Got yeah, it? That.
Oh.
Sorry, Bobby.
You got it going in there. Perfect. Boom. There it is.
There we go. Nice and tight. And there we go. We got our table. We can swirl. You can turn. You can dip.
Hello, look
you
at
can
that.
Share.
Move it all around.
It's
move it all
caring.
Around.
Dun da da dun.
All right. First time using eau toilette. And fortunately, you told me where the light switch was. So that's good. That going.
Eau
light is on.
Toilette.
And there is a shower curtain, which is in a risky spot, so I gotta roll that over the pole at the top.
First one to christen the bathroom!
Yeah, that was pretty spiritual.
Oh.
That was spiritual. No, it was good.
Can we put a halo?
Exactly. Well, you know, it's just a different kind of cassette. Different kind of cassette toilet.
You look comfy, babe.
I am.
And so does Grogu.
He's Grogu. Do me a favor. Will you turn off the lights for Mommy?
Absolutely, Mommy.
Oh, that's impressive.
Thanks, Grogu.
Morning, baby.
Good morning.
Make you some coffee.
Coffee in bed. Nice.
Right? Waking up kind of to the beach side.
Do you know, it's the first time I've ever woke up and there's a beach outside.
I know, look at that.
Now this is not a bad backyard to have, just walking out to the ocean. I mean, look how beautiful that is. Tanya's enjoying it. The skip coming. Oh, nice skip.
Woo!
Nice job, man.
The ocean loves me. Pacific Ocean and I, we have a great relationship.
Yes.
We have this amazing sunset behind us. What an amazing spot for sunsets. You can see it's just a
just heading down now.
Heading down.
And there it goes. Bye-bye, sun.
Well, you know what's funny? You could have just watched that right from our bedroom window.
I know. That's what's amazing.
Look, we can see it right out of our back window. Dave's getting us plugged back up.
Yeah.
Now I'm about to get out cooking. Tonight we're having fajitas. I'm going to try and cook.
Yeah, that's going to be awesome.
Outside.
Outside. Maybe it's warmer inside.
Yeah, well, that's true. Might be warmer inside, but we'll give it a shot. Outside on the induction. Fajitas! So going to cook outdoors for the first time in this electric vehicle, and this is kind of neat. It has like a little bit of a cooking prep standing table, whatever you call it, that's held by this industrial strap here, and also closes up via a magnet. So I love that it has plugs underneath here, which makes it very convenient. So tonight is tonight. So it's a bit chilly out here, I will say that. Being on the ocean, feels right. Cold.
And it's amazing, you still hear the jets and helicopters flying overhead.
Yeah.
Those military ones.
Yeah.
They're non-stop.
They're non-stop. But you know what? I think I'm gonna finish wrapping this up out here. You get inside, warm up, and I'll be right in.
All right, thanks, baby.
Yeah. It's gonna be good.
Thanks, babe. Dinner looks awesome.
Hey.
Appreciate it.
You're very welcome. I got your sauce coming up next.
All right.
Well, a little crispy tortilla on top, and it should be really nice. And then I think we just wind down and chill. Movie and chill, because it's...
I agree.
I'm exhausted. So tired.
Maybe it's cold outside.
I think what I am going to do, though, is I'm going to actually have a shower tonight. I'm going to have a shower.
So Tanya is trying the shower out right now. Now, it's only 2.5 gallon hot water tank. Can you hear that whale pump? Listen. That's a little enclosed sump pump that pumps the water into the gray tank. So, hey babe, how's the shower?
It was 3 minutes.
3 minutes of hot water.
But it lasted. I mean, it was decent. I was really afraid the door was going to pop open.
Right.
Because it has a tendency to do that. And I was afraid it was going to pop open, but the shower curtain was there. Nothing got wet out here. So, I'm happy. Fresh.
We decided to stick around another night on the beach because, well, I mean, look at it. It's so beautiful here outside San Diego. And overall, our experience in the all-electric RV has been really good. Now, it is small, but one of the benefits, too, is just super nimble. You know, even relative to the Echo, it's just kind of fun to drive because being just under 20 feet, you can take this thing anywhere. You can really park it in any spaces. So it's much more easily taken into, say, a city environment where the roads are tight, parking spots are tight, and you can still go and do the things you need to do, almost like you're in just a large like minivan or something like that. The electric RV also drives incredibly smoothly. We, having the electric engine, it's very quiet and the propulsion is very quick, and you like that. Now we love the EcoBoost engine, the gas-powered EcoBoost engine of our Echo, but it's just a totally different experience when you go electric on that. Just that quiet, quick acceleration that you get in the electric is really nice. Now, of course, the electric RV is still certainly limited by the total distance that it can travel on a full charge, and right now, you know, it needs to get further than that.
admittedly. But that's something that Ford and Winnebago, we know, are working on. And so we have high hopes with future rigs as they come out and actually battery technology improves, that that's going to go up quite a bit over time.
Good morning. All right, so you know what? Dave and I have to say this. When we first moved into this all-electric smaller RV, we thought, oh boy, are we going to be able to manage this with two cats? And so once we moved in, we quickly realized, wow, because we're coming from a smaller RV, we were able to adjust to this interior design and layout pretty quickly.
And I definitely loved having the one control panel for everything. I'm talking monitoring your heat, monitoring your water, monitoring your tanks, monitoring your lights. I think that was a real smart use to be able to have one control panel to control all your devices versus multiple ones, which we have in ours.
And I just have to say, you can't deny the fact that not having to go fill up gas or propane for your heat all the time is kind of appealing.
Certainly cannot deny the fact that I could actually sit comfortably on this toilet, which I can't really do in mine because the sink that we have in ours is a little obstruction.
However, in the RV space, one of the biggest things for us is on driving days. If we have an 8-hour driving day, if you have an electric RV, that could easily turn into a 16-hour driving day. And we have noticed different places that we enjoy boondocking and camping, there aren't many accessible electric charging stations for us to be able to go off and enjoy boondocking like we do in our Winnebago Echo. So, with that being said, am I really ready for an electric RV, full electric RV right now? For me, the answer is clear. No, I could not give up Desert Snow for the current electric RV that we have. But I don't know. Hey, Dave. Can you give up electric RVing?
Two additional points. You aren't just recharging your propulsion or chassis battery. You also need to plug in and recharge your house battery that essentially provides all the energy for your living space. Now, in our Winnebago Echo, of course, we do have a lot of lithium batteries that we rely on, but those get recharged from also when we're driving or idling and running our engine. The engine has a second alternator, which recharges those batteries. We're here. You do not have that convenience, and so you're getting some charge from the solar panels themselves, but then really it's plugging those up as well as you drive and go to these different parts. You're also recharging that house system as well as your propulsion system. Second point is that in our Winnebago Echo on a full tank of gas, we can get close to 300 miles, where right now, currently, the electric RV isn't even close to that. So the answer to Tanya's question is that no, at this point, not willing to give up Desert Snow for the electric RV. We love the idea of a full electric RV and we have high hopes for it in the future, but it's just not there yet.
So we just want to let you know we have a full tour on the all new electric RV by Winnebago. If you haven't seen that already, just click the link in the description box below. And we'll see you in the next one.